Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Today we are at the Midland Railway Centre based at Butley, although the main action for this place is in Swanwick, which it takes a day in its own self to go round. It's probably the biggest rail centre that I've been to outside York. It's quite remarkable. Swanwick itself, though, is difficult to get to by road. One way in the lanes is virtually destroyed, and the other way is alongside the county police force, and they try to kid you on that it is not a public right of way. It is. Anyway, enough chat. We've got a lot of silent running to get over, so here we go. Okay, folks, here we are. Now, there's a little lesson here for all of us budding video type people, that if we're going to use an external mic, it's always a good idea to turn it on. So the whole of this first run down the line is silent. Oh, hum. So I might as well put a few words in here that we got there early this morning, that the locomotive you first saw was a type 47, which for a long time was the number one mainline diesel locomotive running at speed on British Rail Metals, or British Railways as it was then. The one that you see there is 47401, without its numbers at the time. She's called Northeastern, and she was knocked out by the Brush Falcon Works in 1962. We'll come across her later on and have a little ride on her, or behind her. The choo-choo we're on at the moment is obviously a steam one. It was designed by Collett. It's an 062 tank, which means no little front wheels, six big driving wheels and two dragging wheels behind. Tanks on the side containing water for the boiler, and she was knocked out in the Great Western factory at Swindon in 1925. It is a Great Western locomotive which at present is running on Midlands metals. So we carry on for a bit longer unless I can think of something else to say. Enjoy it while you can. Okay, having left Butterley behind, we've chundered down the line and we're now approaching Swanwick, which is Swanwick Junction, is the main place I think I mentioned before. It is massive, a bit of a difficult to get to by road, a bit of an actual teaser, but it is worth a full day here anyway to photograph everything and to get round and see everything. What you will find is that people are very, very friendly here. They will happily escort you around places where perhaps if the health and safety dragons and idiots that overly apply health and safety, and I am an ex-safety officer, would perhaps not like them doing. But if they see you are interested, they are interested in you. It has some rather interesting places here. There's the National Centre for Historic Model Railways. There's a static engine house with assorted diesels bolted out the ground. You've got the big locomotive railway shed up the hill with big mainline LMS locos in it, the Coronation and Princess locos. You've got a working shed, a museum shed, couple of diesel sheds, and you have the light railway here, the Golden Valley Light Railway. See its own website on my site and see the my video of it on here as a separate item. But here we are, Swanwick Junction, and if that's not enough for you, you have a quite unique museum here of forklift trucks, of all things. Quite fascinating. You don't even think about them, but yeah, it's here and it's a very valid museum. Next to that, you've got a museum of public transport, basically a bus museum, which is overstocked, way overstocked. So most of the time the doors might be open, but there's barriers preventing you from going in, and it depends on who's on the barriers as to whether or not you can get in there, but you do need to squeeze past them. It's very unfortunate because there is interesting stuff in there. I went through it last year Took some pictures, but all of last year's stuff of that period got lost when a Seagate hard drive went down. Two Seagates and two WDs in the same machine, slight spike, Seagate's gone, WD's still working. Say something. Anyway, carry on. We're now coming towards the end of the line at this end. We're at a village called Ironville, which was built by the Butterley Company to house its residents or its workers. The junction we're coming to is Riddings Junction, which hooks into the main line in the direction of Codnor Park and Ironville. The branch that we go on is a dead end with a runaround. I believe, although only what I've been told, that they hope that one day they can share a station with the main line at Pye Bridge. Best of luck to them. I hope they manage to do it. Another railway is on, of just managing it now at Princess Riceboro. So, best of luck to them. Well, here we go. friendly warning, folks. You may care to adjust your volumes because I have just suddenly found the switch on the microphone. So the silent bit has now come to an end as we start off again at Swanwick.